Hey YouTube, doing a video here of snacking chicken tikka panini. This is from Iceland. Not seen this before. And I'm quite looking forward to trying it. I do like the chicken tikka, and this is 89p at Iceland, 170 grams. So that's the box there. This is the range they do in Iceland. What was the last one I had was that barbecue sub roll pulled pork one, and that was absolutely great. That was amazing, and I bought a few more since I was down there. Just looking at the packet. Not much to chat about really. The cooking instructions is 110. I think it's 110 once, and then flip over 110 again. In a quick look. Oh yeah, cooking instructions. Here we go. Yeah, 110. And then 110 again. Yeah. So that's it there. So let's take the box open. Have a quick look. See what's like before it comes out. So put it in the packet. Looks like a panini. So all we can do now is chuck it in, nuke it out, and see how it comes out in a bit. And the nuke machine. Smelling great. Feeling a bit hard, the top does feel it was quite hard, but it does smell good. I'm just going to flip the lid, let's have a look, see what we're getting. You've got bits of chicken there. Is that onion? I think that's onion. Does that say anything about onion on here? Let's have a look. Ingredients. Breasts, yeah. Onion. Is onion in there? Ugh. Really? I've got eight onion. You can see them there. Not a fan of that. Oh, alright, I wish I never opened the lid, should have just taken a bite. Feels pretty hard as well, straight away now, you know what I'm thinking. Alright, I'm going to take a bite, then we'll be back. There you go. Have a check out Sylvester. The bun, the bottom part is really, really soggy. So take another bite, not really get much from that. Taking a few bites out of that. It's actually It's actually not too bad. I got really put off by the onion then. I was thinking, I'm going to just rubbish this off straight away and just say this is rubbish. I mean, the top part of the panini, really hard, but when you're biting it, it's not tough where you've got to rip it apart with your teeth and that when you're chewing it, and it's not like that. It tastes all right. Bottom bun, still a bit soggy there. That's not too bad. The chicken tikka, the sauce and that, really good. That's nice. And hopefully it's just overpowering the onion, so that's why I can't really taste it. So that's why I'm giving this a better review than probably if I could feel the onion crunching up in my teeth and that, then that would be probably that. But yeah, it's not bad. 89p. Would I get it again? Probably not, because I've seen there's onion in it. So, but you know, I will eat the rest of that, and I'll probably quite happily enjoy it. Would I recommend it to people? Yeah, probably would. And go check it out. You know, it's not bad. The chicken tikka is really nice. The bun, a bit dubious about the. It's pretty hard, but it's not like you've got to chew it apart or anything like that. It's not too much of a struggle with your teeth. You don't have to worry too much. So, yeah, that's the snacking chicken tikka panini. And yeah, go try it. That's all I can say. One note. Anyone notice anything different about my fishbowl? Leave comments below, down there. And we'll see if anyone notices. Anyway, take it easy, YouTube.